Bert Kreischer. Good to see you, Bert. Dude,
I spent all my college with you. Like,
is that right?
I'm being dead serious. It's so creepy running into you because I see you and I go, oh, so many times you'd get out of class, go to the fraternity house, sit in the lounge, and it'd just be you and Stuart Scott. And you just, I mean, that was our day. I used to say, I mean, this is back in the day before phones. So you didn't have like a phone to scroll through. You right. were our scrolling. We just watched you 20 times. Just sit there just all day. Rolling Stone magazine discovered me in 1997.
Yes.
And he said to me, so like, this journalist, like, I'm going to mm-hmm. follow you around for a day.
Right.
So the first day he's like, all right, so what do we do? And I was like, oh, we just watch them all day.
That's me and Stu?
Yeah. And I was like, that's all we're going to do is just watch them all day. And he was like, that's all you do? And after like the third time, I'm like, I guess we should go do something else.
It's amazing. The re-airs of those sports centers that we used to do. You know, we would do them at 1 a.m. and then 2 a.m. again, and then whatever mistakes were made, or if there was somebody having trouble throwing strikes out on the West Coast and a game was going on, inning like 14, 15, yeah. we'd have to sit there and wait till it finished. And we'd be walking off the set 3:30, 4 a.m. in Connecticut, go to sleep, wake up like the next day. We thought, well, like, nobody just watched what the hell we just saw.
Oh, I got the opportunity to
That's the way we were feeling on the other side of the television set.
I got the opportunity to have more than drinks with Stuart Scott.
So when
was this? I'm in New York. This has got to be 2000.
Okay.
And I'm in New York. I'm just starting.
So this is when Stu and I were on the air together.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, okay.
And he is in New York City. He was friends with a friend of mine named Val. And they came and saw me do stand-up. And I get off stage. I did good. If I get off stage, I see Stuart Scott. That's the best, is when you get off stage and you see the celebrity and you're like, oh, I just murdered. They're going to love me.
Right.
And he was like, you're funny. And I was like, oh, thanks. And he was like, we should go get a drink. And I was like, okay, this is before cell phones. This is when you had to talk to someone.
Right.
And so we sat and had drinks. And then he goes, I haven't eaten. Do you mind if I eat? And I was like, oh, yeah. Order a 3-course meal. And we talked. And I was like, what's the one thing I need to know? Because I just started my career. I go, well, how do I make it in this business? Mm-hmm. And he's like, this is where you cringe. He goes, ignore the haters. And I said,
oh, yeah.
And I go, oh, yeah. And he goes, I used to get a lot of hate when I first started. And I go, I know. And he goes, how do you know? And I went, I was like, oh, never mind. I was like, no, I just assumed maybe. But he was great. He was really generous. I ended up having probably 5 drinks. He ate a meal, and it was great. He was a sweet guy.
Oh, I thought the advice he gave you was take your shirt off doing stand-up.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern on Audience.